Alexander Shaw, weighing in at 74 kilos. His record is undefeated. 4 wins and 0 defeats. Fighting out of Dubai, UAE, by way of Tajikistan, Tokir Shirinai. The referee in the action begins, Ilmir Lendosi.
And here we are.
Yeah, this is a big one, guys. Two tough guys here out of Palestine is Omar Hossein in the red. They're in the black and the gray. Tokir Zhirayev. Zhirayev never been beaten here in 4 contests. Looking to keep that undefeated record intact.
For Tokir would be a good strategy to stay up all the fight. He's a good striker. Good kicks, but he needs to keep the distance. Now the fighters are more experienced.
Oh, yeah, and Hossein really wants to bring him down to the ground as well. Submission wrestler, it's what he does. Everything he does is to set up that takedown.
He's likely trying to figure out the distance there and just steady
nice
himself.
Nice counter, low leg.
Yeah.
Low kick there.
Couple of the rising stars here at UAE Warriors, 5-1, Omar Hossein. Coming out of Amman, Jordan. They have a great team there in Amman. Fantastic fighters starting to come out of that region. Nice right hand by Tokir. Tokir with that stand-up. And now he's going to look for a single leg. He may be making a mistake here.
Setting the pace in here right now.
He should keep it standing up.
No, but he's going to get it. But look at that underneath the chin. And that's trouble.
Guillotine attempt.
Let's see. I don't like that. Hossein pulling on that neck, and he's still got a good angle on it.
Yeah, but good defense. He's defending correctly, putting his shoulder.
So he was just basing up. Great defense, and he gets out of it. How tough is Tokir Zhirayev?
What an amazing fight, man. So exciting. So much excitement in the very beginning on Bravo.
Oh, here we go.
He gave up the second submission.
Jeez.
I wish he insisted a little bit more. He had a good position there.
But still, man, if you're his opponent and you felt the pressure of that, that's something that you try to stay away from that choke now. How do you think?
Nice inside.
Do you think Omar will try?
Yeah, you got to believe he's going to try to bring that fight to the ground.
You know what?
Especially after coming real close on the guillotine.
Yeah, standing up is not for Omar. It's not a good choice to exchange with Tohir. That's what his coach is saying, Tarapoyoka. You know, definitely. Oh, nice left hook. Landed. Visually tired.
Oh, to get that punches combination, but it's now
right over the top. Nice left, right. Ooh, look at that body shot. Tokir Zhirayev is a tough dude.
Not thinking that much on going to the takedown again after that guillotine.
He left that leg out there.
Yeah.
I think the stand-up is going to be the difference maker here because it seems like Tokir Zhirayev has a decent takedown and takedown defense game. So I think it's going to come down to the better striker.
Yeah, Tokir would say is a better striker, but he's paying a price.
Oh, here we go.
This first exchange. He found the distance. He has a very good sense of distance. He lands a lot of punches.
Yeah, good instincts here by the very young Zhirayev. Jeez. Outside leg kick rippling through the entire arena.
Nice. Landed again. Left hook.
Ooh, there comes that combo.
Another one.
Seems like only a matter of time. Tokir just continues to touch him up.
He finds the distance. He's hunting. He's hunting Omar around the ring. See how he moves away from the fight.
Yeah, but Omar is doing well walking backwards and attacking at the same time. That's not a very easy thing to do.
He's going to get that takedown. At least he should in the eyes of the judges.
15 seconds to the end of the fight. That was a mistake from Tokir. He was had the advantage maintaining the distance.
Yeah, that may make a difference, guys. That could be the difference maker. Very, very tight rounds. I think Tokir Zhiraev probably landed more significant strikes, so if that's what you're going to judge the round on, then I would probably give it to Zhiraev. But also that very, very tough guillotine attempt as well, and the Bravo choke back-to-back. So it really depends on the judges. A lot of judges have not evolved. They just go by takedowns. They don't necessarily go by damage done. So it could be interesting to see how they judge that first round.
Yeah, I think that the judges here, they've been to a long process of going through the unified rules. So I expect them to be able to judge back at least better than I can. But there is... Everybody has a bias to give more importance to the end of the fight. And the end of the fight was a takedown and a nice elbow from Omar on Tokir. But I don't know. I think it's close.
But I want to see how Tokir will...
Yeah, it is. You're right.
We'll see how Tokir will act now because he got countered several times, not only on the floor but also standing. Moving backwards, Omar managed to drop some good shots, you know.
Let's see what the coach told them during the break.
I think Omar's going to go for the takedown a little bit earlier this time. I see him going and bringing it to the ground soon.
Yeah, me too.
Tokir doesn't have a whole lot of accuracy, but
nice. Again, a right hook landing once more.
Ooh, there we go. Setting it up, going to the body. Tokir definitely has the advantage on the feet.
And he gets more confident as the round progresses, you see, and he finds his distance.
I'd like to see him throw more straight punches. He just throws a lot of wild haymakers and bolo punches. Usually it's those fighters that can do it right down the middle that have the most success.
Yeah, that's correct. But he does land a lot, that hook. It's not with knockout power so far, but he does have a good distance.
Both of them landed. And Omar had a fantastic counterpunch, and he's going to move in.
Oh, he landed the left as well, Omar.
Omar, he saves those big punches, but when he throws them, he lands them.
To apply the best.
In the end of the fight, would you say?
Yeah. Oh, nice. He listened to you. It was a jab.
I love when the fighters listen to me. Over the top with the right hand.
Yeah.
Well, he's making Hussein think about it. You know, he's...
Now he goes for the takedown. Not what I would suggest. If he's winning the fight standing up, why change the... Oh.
I'm just surprised that Omar hasn't shot.
Me too, man.
Yeah.
Try to time that thing and go for a shot.
Oh, not a jab. Nice one.
He's going to end up going out on his feet. Tokir, he's a very... Very, very confident with that striking. And here comes the takedown, but that one was telegraphed, and Tokir quickly gets the underhook and stays on his feet. And this may be a confidence breaker here for Omar Hossein. He can't get the takedown, and Tokir just slowly but surely touching him up. Oh, nice, nice left, left by Omar.
Yeah, they clearly Tohir has an advantage on standing up and Omar on the takedowns, but they are actually both areas, they are quite close to each other. It's not like a huge difference.
Now Tohir's going to try to even things up, but he's going to walk right into a guillotine potentially. He separates Zhirayev, Tohir Zhirayev. He's trying to get that timing down. Let's see if he can land. See if he goes to that left hook.
Oh,
nice left hook, man.
On the jaw. He really sets his feet and fires out hard, too. He puts a lot of power besides every punch. Omar Hossein goes by 187.
Another jab landed.
Another one, man. He landed like maybe three, four clean jabs so far.
And now he found himself on the low kicks.
Yeah, I would like to see
forcing
him
Omar to change the stance. Did you see that? He even had to change the stance to protect his leg. Yeah. Let's see if Tohir will throw another one.
Oh, yeah. You can take a look at that knee and those legs of Hossein, and they are starting to get red right around the knee area. Even to the point where he did have to change his stance there for a moment. Mubadala Arena here,
nice
UAE Warriors number 8.
Right. It's not a huge, huge advantage for either of them. They're technically quite close. Double jab, nothing landed.
Oh, nice
right hand from Tohir.
Right,
he feels confident. Oh, that was a mistake. 15 seconds to the end of the fight. He had the advantage, the most significant strike so far, and then he ends up getting taken down at the end of the fight.
So definitely the fight going the way Omar Hossein is planning, because man, 30 seconds to the end of the fight, once again he gets a takedown out of nowhere. Nice timing. That's why when we saw that double leg in first round, I thought he would try that tool at the very beginning of the second round, but no, he's really using that as a strategy just to get the points out of it. So once again, I will tell you, man, Tohir's been landing like clean jabs all the time, but at the same time his right hand is going down, so he's getting countered with the Omar's left hook quite often. He landed good left hooks. So because of those two takedowns, would you count the two rounds to Omar or still?
Man, this
it's too technical.
He's landing a lot of significant punches.
Yeah.
I would give it to Tohir, but you know, I could definitely be wrong because this fight is too close.
Too close.
It's way
so
too close.
Yeah.
Yes. Let's see the third, final round.
Let's see if any of them will try to change the strategy.
They are technically very close. Tohir is definitely better in stand-up fighter, and Omar better on the ground. But they are close. They are not dominant on either way. Oh, nice, Diash Barai.
Nice knee. Now it looks better positioned, that hand for the guillotine. Okay, well defended by Tohir.
Tries to take down and see Tohir now grabs
Omar
the cage.
Again.
Uses the cage to avoid a takedown, but not for long. Now Omar managed to put him down. And now is the time to define the fight. Early on the fight, like this, 4 minutes to go.
Tohir trying to...
Yeah, to do a kidney squeezer.
Yeah, I gotta tell you, man, it hardly works. I'm not saying it doesn't work, but it hardly works. Good movement. Reaching the half guard.
Nice half guard control for Omar at this stage. The fight's going towards him now.
Using the shoulder under his opponent's
shirt. Oh, he's passed to the mount.
Get into the mount position. It
and
looks
he
like
does
he's
have
getting,
a good position for the
katakata. Yeah.
Exactly.
He's trying to set up that katagatami.
Yeah. He gave up the katagatami to get the most of the mount position. Oh, I managed. And there is 3 minutes to fight to go.
It's a matter of managing.
But
the
how
pressure.
Much defending well? He's defending well to here, but
yeah, but say not a whole lot of pressure on him. I don't think from that angle.
Yeah, but it's a lot of time.
It's a terrible trap. It's a terrible trap. It's so hard to.
And the other, and also his arm is exposed. Now it's getting worse
now
and worse.
For the arm bar.
Oh, he's almost escaping from it.
Yeah, exactly. The arm bar is where he needs to go with this because he's just not
he's
getting the
get
pressure
out.
He wants.
I think he's going to get out from it.
No idea why he's not stretching that arm, man.
No idea why his coach is not screaming, goes
okay,
for the arm bar.
Now he got it.
Yeah, and then as he goes, the triangle gets deeper. He's almost out, but Omar's legs are too big for his own good, man. That's the thing. He has too much of long legs to get a tight triangle. But now Tohir is exhausted, you can tell. Because he spent a lot of energy to try not to tap out. They're both gone.
Yeah, no, they're both in
but
a bad
they
place
still
right
have
now.
Good, they're still able to put some good techniques there. Let's see. It will be hard for Tohir to get back from it. They're both landing shots. Omar tries another takedown. Oh, look at that. Tohir is wobbling around. Resisting those submissions attempts what text him a lot. Got a left hook. So Omar landed a left hook. Nice low kick. He could bag this fight if he plays it well, Omar. But he cannot give time for Tohir to recover. And Tohir is already recovering. See how he's moving a little bit better. Still locking the knees as he walks. So it's a sign of being exhausted. But what warriors those guys.
But tough task right now.
Nice
for
calf.
For Tohir to get away from.
Look at the calf of Tohir now. Nice. He's recovering. You see how he's a little bit faster movement. He's getting back. This guy is very, very extremely well conditioned. Bit of a mistake from Omar to allow Tohir to recover.
I mean, guys, we got 30 seconds left. Where do you see this fight going?
I think Omar takes this fight. But it's hard.
Yeah, the ground control, in my opinion, gives the fight is more towards Omar. But
nice
the amount of
hook.
Punches, like jabs and
yeah, Tohir landed much more, and also more.
Well, supposedly you don't put as much emphasis on just controlling on the ground anymore when it comes to MMA. It really comes down to damage. So it's going to be interesting. Just like that last fight. When we were all, or the first fight, when we thought for sure Golmamadov had it, one judge had it the other way, too.
Yeah,
so,
that's
you
correct.
Know.
Yeah, but you got to say that Omar was closer to a win. He got that submission in, he attacked the arm, he almost got the triangle done. So I think that counts a lot.
Absolutely. Yes, indeed. But another tight fight here. We've had some nights where we have a lot of finishes, and then some nights where they go down to the nitty gritty every fight, and it looks like that's what we're looking at here.
Yeah. But so far, so good. Very high level fights, all of them. I like when the card has lighter fighters. I actually enjoyed a lot those type of fights. So what do you say, Polonio? Would you give to Tohir or? Omar.
I would go for Omar, but it was a super technical fight, as you were saying. Like the amount of times that Tohir landed jabs on Omar, that would can give him the fight.
Yeah. ladies and gentlemen, after three hard fought rounds, we go to the judges' scorecard for a decision. The judges see this fight 30-27, 30-27, and 29-28. All your winner out of unanimous decision from the blue corner.
Yeah, that's correct.
Yeah, we're talking about like the end of the two rounds. Made good to clean takedowns and the takedown and the ground control as well. He also landed some good punches like the
left
hooks.
Yeah, both of them landed. Yeah. I think that's the key, because Omar also landed.
Yeah, he landed some good left hooks.
Yeah,
countering.
But warriors, both of them, amazing
fight, lots of heart. Yeah, yeah. In order to put a good fight, you need a good opponent. If it's too easy, it goes away like
right.
nothing.
That's
you know?
True. Like the matchmaking of those fights are just
amazing. Yeah.
Very, very nice.
Yeah, it's nice for people to understand. Like, we see only 15 minutes of 15 minutes of the fighters in here, but in the end we have to it is a very rough place to be, like training daily. It's a lot to put, and a fighter is so passionate about the sports, you know. But at the beginning there's no money, no nothing. So
yeah, now we're gonna have our first female fight.